Well, actually, on 9/11 itself, I mean, I'm not a structural engineer, and that's where Richard Gage comes in, and he can speak to it much more articulately than I can from the structural standpoint. But there was a makeshift, I can speak to this, there was a makeshift morgue on Liberty Island. That's where the, Statue of Liberty right there. And we were expecting 20,000 bodies. It was very hectic that day. I sort of try to forget it, try to, subliminally push it down, but my XO at the time, now, I wasn't there, I wasn't present when he heard it, but he was in civilians, he was in the civvies, he was in civilian clothing, so he was taken in and mistakenly taken in as military. Now, I didn't hear this, I wasn't there, but he was taken into a briefing, and they had a satellite overlay of Ground Zero with a bunch of, red dots. And it was UEDs, unexploded devices. Now, that's not hearsay. He told me that, and I won't say his name on air. But it was Army Corps of Engineers. It was all branches of the military. And then there were actually passes. Now, that I saw, they actually had passes, printed passes to get in.
Yeah, they were already ready within hours to control the crime scene because they needed to control it. They needed to make sure that evidence was covered up. I want to go to Luke Radowski here in a few minutes, but I want to keep you on. Specifically, when you first called in yesterday, you were and we ran out of time, you were talking about other issues, other instances. You mentioned 93. You mentioned other things that had happened.
Well, there's the blind sheik. See, again, I'm treading on grounds here, but the blind sheik.
Sheikh Abd el Rahman out of the New Jersey pizza place.
Yeah, right above. It was above the pizza place. That's in General Square. There is all kinds of intel that we simply don't have access to. And now we're the Jersey City Police Department. How do we don't have a terrorist task force? If it is a so-called hotbed of terrorist activity, how are we not involved?
Well, you know about Ahmad Salam. The FBI hires him. They have him cook the bomb, train the driver.
Yes.
This is real Muslim terrorists, but they literally create the group, point it at the Trade Center, tell them to park it up against the pillar. Thank God they didn't. That's on record because Ahmad Salam figured out they were setting him up. Because he wasn't really a Muslim extremist. He had been hired to do this by the FBI. He recorded them, so they had to pay him $1.3 million. But I mean, look, it's been in the New York papers, the New Jersey papers, the Pennsylvania papers, that the firefighters and police found 3 of the 4 boxes. That's actually come out in congressional testimony, and the FBI seized them. Why grab the flight recorders? What are they covering up?
The way it works now is it really is like TV. I mean, it really is like the movies. The way they portray the relationship between local police and FBI. When the Fed comes on the scene and the local cop just flips them off, and that's pretty much the way it is. We're just glorified security guards. So we don't have access to this.
Well, the way it's supposed to work, unless it was a federal marshal with a directive from the president or the Congress, they're not supposed to be involved. You see, everything is ass backwards, excuse that term, but that's what it is. It's all backwards. The states are supposed to be sovereign, and they're supposed to kiss your boots, not the other way around.
But you know what? To take that posture, what you want to do is, I think we just need more access.
But that's not going to happen as long as we have feds running things. Look, the feds covered up for Madoff while he stole not a 50, but $100 billion. Okay, and now they're covering for him again. So, the feds are foreign. It's a foreign bank has hijacked America. It's a corporate takeover. Any other key points concerning 9/11 or anything else about your XO, your commander, going in there and into that military briefing, out there at the makeshift morgue, out there at the Statue of Liberty, and anything else he saw in those overlays? Any other little tidbits that are important for people out there?
Now, it was basically, an overlay map, satellite overlay. And again, I didn't see this. This is a corner of my XO. And that The Army Corps had, you know, had sealed it off. Now, that was later on that night. That was actually after Plaza 7 fell. So I got evacuated from Battery Park. So we went directly from Battery Park to Liberty Island. Now I just sort of like, we just sort of like brushed, you know, we brushed each other as he went in. And then when he came out, he had this like, we felt a look on his face. And I asked him, I said, you know, what's going on? You know, and actually my badge number was 9/11 on 9/11. And he looked at he looked at my badge number and goes, you know, your badge number is 9/11. I remember he was the first individual to say that to me.
That's amazing. Well, I mean, I know you had Richard Gage into town to speak to folks. Did that have an effect on your colleagues?
No. You know, I think it's a befuddlement. I think people just can't wrap their minds around it. And tell you the truth, you know what they're most likely going to do? Now, I'm a 15-year vet. You know, they're going to wind up, you know, sending me for a psych. I'm staying as the next guy. But, you know, I know what I'm up against here. I know what's going to happen.
Yeah, and I guess if you show them all the CNN clips of them saying they blew the building up, I guess that's all them need psych evaluations as
well. Yeah, we're all a bunch of testosterone-driven, you know, knuckleheads that...
Well, as more of you stand up and speak out, we commend your courage, we're not going to be able to get away with this. The establishment wouldn't be attacking us with all these TV shows and programs if it wasn't happening. Let's bring up Luke Radowski. Stay there, Detective Carroll. Luke, now We Are Change. He's the founder of We Are Change, wearechange.org, 100-plus chapters all over the world, 9/11 Truth and other activism against the globalist. Now you guys, Luke, have the FBI going around asking questions about you. We know you've got infiltrators trying to stir stuff up. Things are getting serious. Tell us the latest chapter, Luke.
You mean the new chapter that we have in our organization?
No, the new chapter in harassment.
Well, just 2 weeks ago, we had Jesse Ventura and many 9/11 family members and rescue workers down at Ground Zero. We're out there every Saturday giving out free DVDs and free flyers to the public out there about the truth behind 9/11. And 2 weeks ago, we had Jesse Ventura. And then last week, we had one of our supporters. We have many supporters at the Ground Zero community that support us and are huge fans of ours but are not members. And one of the people that, you know, just works down at Ground Zero, he wished not to be disclosed, said he was questioned by the FBI, people with FBI badges, about our group. And he just came to us last week. This is the week before we had Jesse Ventura, family members, rescue workers down at Ground Zero. And, you know, that's why they came down there, because we're having a huge effect at Ground Zero.
You know, I haven't been keeping touch with Jesse or you guys. I've been so busy on other things. But I didn't know Ventura was up in New York. I wish you guys would let me know about that. I'd have come in.
Jesse Ventura was there for only a little bit. He was shooting a pilot for his series that he's working on.
Yeah, I knew he was going back to New York for that. Yeah.
Yeah, and he stopped by Ground Zero. We had a lot of family members, a lot of rescue workers. It was an amazing day 2 weeks ago at Ground Zero. It was really.
How long
really
was he at Ground Zero?
What happened?
How long was he at Ground Zero?
He's only there for, you know, about around an hour or so. Not that long at all.
I need to give him a call. He emailed me the other day. I need to give him a call because I'm working with him on that. We'll see where that TV program goes. Luke, what do you think of Detective John Carroll and what he has to say?
I mean, it's a beautiful thing. We definitely need more police officers and more people in the military on our side. We get a lot of support, again, in the community at Ground Zero from a lot of people. And it's sad seeing these people being questioned and harassed by the FBI about our organization. But again, we have nothing to hide. We're a peaceful organization. We want to work with the police, with the military, against the elite, against the New World Order that enslave us.
Yeah, stay there, stay there. Fighting for the interest of the United States against the New World Order. We're the true patriots.
Don't send your kin folks to give me no talking. I'll be gone, like I said.
Yeah, it was lonely.
You'd say the same
years before 9/11, making films about government-sponsored terrorism, like America Destroyed by Design in 97, Police State 2000, and other documentaries. And then months before 9/11, saying, call the White House, tell them don't blow up the World Trade Center. First and only time I've said, call the White House and tell them don't blow up the buildings. because I could see all the preparation on the news, the preparation of the public mind, and that's on record. You know, that aired many times on Access TV that I aired July 25th live, and I turned the tape in that day, and it aired a few times. It aired on the morning of 9/11 again, and we got a bunch of death threats. People thought I was on there on the day saying it was an inside job when it was 2 months old. But Jimmy Vaughn, my good friend, who I didn't even know at the time, he saw me live say call the White House. He was on the fence about me. And then 2 months later, he saw the attack on the World Trade Centers, and he said, oh, my God, this stuff is really accurate. So, you know, I'm on record saying that, and that's what studying these people can do for you. You can really understand where they're going to strike next, their basic psychology, their criminology.